here.
Okay. Well, good morning. Thank you for coming for my presentation. My name is José Manuel Ortega. I come from Spain, and this is my first time here in FOSDEM. And well, this talk is oriented also, for security researchers, analysts that are interested in knowing open source intelligence with Python. Well, this tool is a complement that was made for EuroPython last year. The link is available in my personal site. This tool that was made last year is oriented to pen testing with Python, the main tools that we have in Python, and what are the main modules that we can use for develop our own pen testing tool. Well, some of the samples that I will comment in this presentation are available in my personal GitHub repository. I comment some of these samples, like the Shodan, extracting metadata from image and documents, and for example the obtain information from GitHub repositories for a specific user or company. Well, this is the main points I will talk. I will make a little introduction to what is OSINT, a definition. Later, I will comment what are the main sites that provide obtain server information, public information that is available on the internet, and services like Censis and Shodan provide recover all the information that is servers, operating systems, and so on. Later, I will comment what are the main tools that we can find in Python ecosystem for OSINT. And later, some samples for obtaining geolocation, extracting metadata from documents, and other tools for footprinting. What is OSINT? Basically, OSINT is the acronym of Open Source Intelligence, and with OSINT we can extract, in general, information from social networks, and in general public sources that are available in internet. We can obtain technical data from servers, service, software, operating systems, all other information related with social media, emails, photos from social networks, IP addresses, footprinting information from services, and other information related with network and operational intelligence. What information we can extract with OSINT techniques? For example, the geolocation of a server or a service, the IP address, email address of a person, the telephone number of a specific company or user, usernames in social network profiles. Also, we can obtain extract metadata information from images and documents. And finally, obtain in general server information and obtain vulnerabilities in this service. I'm starting with Censis. Censis basically provides a lot of information about Censis internally. What is that? Is crawling the web, obtaining information about IP addresses, host servers, and so on, and save this information in a database basically it provides a JSON 600 gigabytes and all information about IP addresses, certificates, location of the servers, and so on. In an easy way with Thensys, Thensys provides a REST API for obtaining information. For example, if we want to obtain the information from an IP address or domain, we can use this REST API. Where in this example, we can see that from a specific domain, we can obtain the geolocation of the domain, information related with certificates about the site, subdomains. Also, we can obtain this kind of information. Shodan is another service like Thensys. Shodan provides another database for recovery to all this information that is available in the internet. All this information is public. And Shodan provides also this. With Shodan, we can find, in Python, we have a Shodan module that provides, that we can use for searching in Shodan API with Python. We need first to register in Shodan site and obtain a Shodan IP key. And with this API key, we can make a search by host, by IP address, and so on. And in general, all information we can obtain the organization, the operating system, and in general, all banners, servers that provide this site. For example, if we try to look for the end of the domain, we obtain the organization, the operating system where is the server executing, and for each port, if it's open, the port detects the banner of the port, the server, the operating system, and so on. All this information about Shodan is available also if we search by in shodan.io/host. We can check that the data, this data with passing the IP address, and the information is the same. With Shodan also we can detect vulnerabilities that are available in the common vulnerability and exposure database. Also we can obtain this information. For example, if the server is executing an OpenSSL version that has vulnerabilities, with this simple script, we can check that this kind of vulnerability. Shodan also provide a developer API. Instead of using the Python module, we can use a classical REST API for making the request. For example, if we want to obtain the last search that users made in Shodan services, we can use the data specific REST API called query search that returns all the requests that users are executing in Shodan. Well, the next tool that we comment. Well, this is the first tool that we comment that is developed in Python. ReconNG. ReconNG is one of the most known open source intelligence. It's very maintained. It's available in Bitbucket repository. And internally, is the architecture of this tool is based in modules and recollect all information in database. This tool is developed in Python 2, and the main modules that is using, we can highlight, for example, Dennis Python, LSML for parsing the information, also other tools like Mechanize, PyPyDF for extracting metadata from PDF documents, and SQLite for persisting the data. Well, the architectural record of this tool is based in modules. If we type in the console show modules, it shows information what are the modules available in this tool. We have modules for discovery information in for exploit also. Other tools, other modules that we have are, for example, contacts, obtain credentials, obtain domains, or obtain subdomains for a specific target, recollect contacts for a specific email address, for example. In this example, we can see that with the Freo GeoIP module, we can extract the geolocation of the fosden.org domain. Basically, what provides is this module provides an options. They are default options, but for example, if we want to extract information for a specific domain, we need to set the server URL parameter. Also, we can extract subdomains for a specific domain. In this case, it's using the API doc target /host-search, and the idea is obtain all subdomains that are in the main domain that we are analyzing. Also, this tool is integrated with Shodan API. With Shodan API, we can also obtain the subdomains for a specific domain. In this example, we can see that extract subdomains, other hosts that are available in the site, IP addresses in version 4 and 6. Well, another interesting tool for investigating with those techniques in Python is the Harvester. The Harvester is one of the main tools for obtaining, for example, information about email addresses, subdomains, and so on. Basically, the Harvester tool is developed in a modular way. We can find files for making search in Google Search, in Bing, in other social networks like LinkedIn, Twitter, Shodan. The main modules that are using for develop this tool are HTTP lib, socket request, and Shodan. In this example, we can see that for extracting, for example, the emails for a specific domain and other subdomains or hosts or other IP addresses, for example, with the B parameter, we can specify the search engine that we want to use. In this case, we are using the Google search engine over the domain pycon.org, and with the L parameter we can specify the limit of the results. And in this example we can see that in a nice way we can extract all information of the domain. Another tool interesting. This tool is developed by a group of of people, of research people in Spain, in a group of security researchers. This tool is available in GitHub repository, and we can install this tool with pip, with pip install. It's developed in Python 2.7 and integrates with Maltego Transforce for obtaining more information with the target that we are analyzing. The main modules that this tool is using are, for example, Beautiful Soup for passing the data of the web, Requests, Mechanize, PyDNS, Python Whois for recovering information, Whois information about the specific domain, TweetPy for connecting with Twitter, Skype for Pi for connecting with Skype, and other, for example, Python email for checking email addresses. This tool has some scripts that we can execute. These scripts can execute separately each one of other. For example, if we want to obtain the, we have the search file.py script. If we want to, we need to extract the information about a specific user or a specific domain, you can use the p parameter with Twitter for searching all the accounts related with Twitter that match with the fosdem, in this case with the fosdem name, and reduce all the accounts in Twitter that match with the Twitter account. We have another script related with the previous script that we find with the fosdem name. It returns all the other network profiles, other social network profiles that match with this name. This tool is has the capacity to connect with more than 2,000 platforms in general, social networks, and it has the capacity to find all this information or to find this information in this in a lot of platforms. Well, this tool I'm commenting now is developed also in Python 2.7. It's called Spiderfood. Spiderfood is oriented to tags, footprinting tags for discovering subdomains and other information related with the target that we are analyzing. Internally, it's using Beautiful Soup, then Python, Socket, Cherry Pie for building the website. And another modules, for example, NetAddress or PyPI for extracting metadata from PDF documents. This tool has the capacity to connect with many data sources. For extracting all data, that we will see an example, it has the capacity to connect with many data sources and match relation of all results in a graphical way. For example, if we want to extract, we want to search, for example, the other repositories related with the domain that we are analyzing, we can use this tool for obtaining this kind of results. In this example, we are obtaining GitHub repositories related with the domain that we are analyzing. And also, in a graphical way, we can obtain we can see the relation between fosdem.org domain and other subdomains, social networks, social profile networks, and so on. For example, if we want to extract information about a specific author in a GitHub repository, we can use the api.github.com/repos/users, and in an easy way we can obtain information like this. For example, if we want, if we need to share by for then domain, we can see that the results by this. We obtain issues URL, deployments URL, another URLs then related with the target that we are analyzing. For extracting metadata, basically we can extract metadata where we are analyzing or researching in obtaining metadata. We have two modules, one PDF2 and PDF miner for extracting metadata from PDFs, and for extracting metadata from image we have some modules. For example, we have Pylo and PSIF2 in Python 2.7, and if we need to go to Python 3 we have GXIF2. In this example we can see that we are extracting metadata from an image and obtaining for example the GPS info with the latitude and longitude values and other information that is stored in the image in a inside. For obtaining geolocation, also we have the GeoIP2 module, and basically with this module we can specify the IP address, and it returns all the geolocation of this IP address. It returns city, country, and a lot of information related with the geolocation. Internally, is need to use a file called geolittlecity.mmdb. This is like a database that has a lot of information with the relation between IP addresses and the geolocation of this IP address. Well, until now, all tools that I have seen are developed in Python 2. But the question is possible to develop a tool of this kind in Python 3? Yes, the question is yes, it's possible. We have a beautiful SU for passing web information. We have requests or URL for synchronous requests. We have async IO or IHTTP for asynchronous. We have Scrappy for web crawling or web browser. We have POGP for geolocation. We have another modules for connecting with social networks like Python Twitter or TwiPy, and also Shodan and Dynis Python. All these modules are compatible with Python 3, and the answer is yes. The only this is one of the tools that I have seen that are developed in Python 3. It's called Web of Information Gather, and it's a very simple tool that what it does is recovering all basic information about a specific website. It detects the operating system, the version of the server that is executing, subdomains of the site, and extract more information related with this site. And finally, if we want to extract information for Twitter, for example, we have TeamFolic. TeamFolic is developed by a Spanish security researcher, and it provides many parameters. For example, we can filter the result by star or end date. We can find information about a specific user account, like hashtags, mentions, metadata information from image and media. Well, for finishing, for using this tool, we need to configure first the a little file for where we need to put the typical information about a consumer key, access token that we can find in a developer Twitter API. Also, we can extract your location. If the user is the account of the user is activated, the geolocation of the user is activated in user accounts, we can obtain this coordinates, geolocation, latitude, longitude. And finally, the full content API provides another way of extract information about a person from an email address. In a easy way, we can, for example, obtain only the information about the specific email, the employees of this person, other social networks, other social profile networks of this person. Also, this API, we can use this API for extracting information from a specific domain. In this case, we are extracting what are the social networks that match with this domain. Well, all these tools, some of the tools that I comment are available in Kali Linux. Like, for example, we can find Recon NEG, the Harvester, are available in Kali Linux. And that's all. These are the reference and the books. Thank you. Some question? No. Okay.